What's up, everybody? Welcome back to My Twisted Life and TV. I am Poetry. You are here for another recap and review. This is Ready to Love, Season 5, Episode 9. Out of town and out of bounds. On the trip and tripping out. Something of that nature. I watched this Friday night. Let me tell you, I had to calm myself down. I had to calm myself down and rewatch certain scenes again to make sure that I heard what I thought I was hearing. Now, before I get started, I'm going to tell you, before this episode even aired, I want to say it was last week or earlier this week, they had showed a clip of what was supposed to happen in this particular episode. And Kamil was all... it's something in this room. Kamil was already... on Commission Reviews channel telling her, if you want to know what really happened in this little edited up clip, I'm ready to interview. I'm telling y'all, Kamil is strictly here for entertainment purposes only. She wants to be a reality TV star. She just don't want to be on a reality TV show. She wants to be an actual star. That's why she acts a damn fool when she comes in front of the camera. This is all an act. It's something in this room is lighting my ass up. I don't know. So, last week Tommy told us that everybody's about to do a getaway. They always do this, send everybody to a house, and then everybody's supposed to narrow down their choices once they get to this house. So everybody is dead set on getting answers on this getaway. In particular, Mumin. Walter says that Mumin and Sabrina is his choices. Frank says it's Mumin and Sydney. Zadia says it's Dante and Naeem. Sydney thinks it's Phil and Frank. Shiloh, she only checking for Phil right now. Only checking for Phil. She's been flying under the radar. Kamil and Cornelius, they are there strictly for each other and nobody else. Naeem, he's only feeling Zadia. Sabrina, only feeling Walter. Again, two more people flying under the radar. Aisha and Phil, they got options. They got options, baby. Pretty much below that, everyone expects to walk away from this trip with a little bit more clarity than what they did before. Okay, so we start off. That don't even sound right. We start off in the car. On a car ride. We ain't never had car rides up to these trips before. But we get the scene with Kamil hollering the question to Cornelius, are we sharing a room or not? So are we sharing a room or not? Okay, that's how she started off. He like, I said, yeah, I already said, yeah, it's cool, we could share a room. Baby, if that ain't bullying, if that ain't being bullied in a relationship, I don't know what it is, right? So Zadia is riding up there with them. And she in the back like, I'm so glad y'all found a love connection. That's beautiful. What is beautiful about the way that she talks to him? What is beautiful about that? Y'all are some plum fools. Some plum fools. Cornelius like, Zaza, come on now. What you trying to do? So like I said, everybody's headed up to this little lodging that Tommy has set up for them. First time we get to see the car rides. Cornelius got Kamil, Zadia. You know, and he considers himself to be part of the brown girl crew because that's what they call themselves. Zadia, Mumin, and Kamil. I already told y'all how these girls are connected to each other outside of the show, prior to this show. And Zadia is like, he calling me Zaza. He just want to be part of the crew so bad. You know, I think Kamil said that he was like the president of the fan club of the brown girls crew. But yeah, they say he want to be part of the brown girls so bad. They said it, not me. Okay, I'm not going to say it this week. But y'all already know what I'm thinking about Cornelius. Now, Mumin didn't ride with him. You know what? I really need to change rooms. I really do. Maybe it's fleas or something in here. I don't know. I know they turned me up. I'm in an Airbnb, right? Okay, so nobody sleeps in this room. It's just a room that I use to record in. Maybe I need to come sit off of like a little air bomb or something. Because they turn me up. It's something flat around in this mug. Anywho. So the brown girl crew, like I said, they think that because they some sexy chocolate women, they are the brown girl crew, and they just vibe like that. You know what I'm saying? Y'all was already cool before the show started. Let's not even play, okay? Y'all are some beautiful women with some nasty ass fucking attitudes. Some nasty attitudes. Well, we see Sabrina. She's riding up with Walter. Now she wants to know if they already booed up. Are we a couple now? Do you see us as a couple? Now they don't show us what his answer was, so it made it seem like he wasn't giving her one. Sabrina said, "You know, I'm not trying to make anybody mad," and she's referring to Mumin. Then we go back to Kamil, saying that she expect there to be drama this weekend. And Kamil like, "No, not Kamil." Cornelius like, "No, not no drama. I don't want no drama." We've seen the tension between these ladies in the past couple weeks. But the brown girl squad is in the building, and they are presenting themselves to be mean girls. Bitches. Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm picking up for them. They not just act like mean girls. They act like bitches. That's what they act like to me. So Zadia, she like, okay, she's just throwing out random ass questions. So whose house are y'all gonna move into? Camille say, whose house? No, we're gonna buy us a new house after we get married. We're gonna buy us a brand new house. Camille already has them at their silver anniversary with the grandkids, having grandkids up in joint. That's how she see them already. Cornelius is like, hey, slow up. One step at a time, one day at a time. I can see potential, you know what I'm saying? I can see us going in the right direction. But that's not what Camille wanted to hear right now. She says she's 1,000% sold on that relationship that he need to be too. He ain't giving the right answers. So for that, she gonna give him attitude. She's making a conscious decision to give him attitude, right? I would say Cornelius run. But at this point, he sees the red flags. He knows that they're there. He's acknowledging them. He's making the conscious choice to ignore them. So he's not really acknowledging them. He know they there. He just said, you know what, I don't want to see him right now. And that's basically what it was. You know what I'm saying? And it made me wonder if this is the type of relationship that he grew up with. Was his mama this way with his daddy? I find that a lot of times when the mother is very dominating, very abusive in nature, verbally, physically, to the man in the household, that the young man sees this as the way to be, so to speak. I had an ex, and his father used to beat the shit out of his mother. And the first time I heard it, I was on the phone. I heard it. I was like, what the hell is going on? He was like, oh, they just fighting. What are you doing in the process? You're a grown ass man. He still lived at home. A lot of Caribbean men still live at home with their parents. He was still a grown man. And I was like, you ain't gonna intervene? I don't know how many times he had intervened before. Found out never. Because he said, all grown up through his whole life, this is the way it's always been. What he normally does is go in his room and shut the door. I was like, that don't make sense to me, right? Well, in his mind, because his father was the breadwinner, he was the man of the house. So whoever is the breadwinner in the household has the right to discipline anyone else in the household, including their partner. So in our situation, he gave me an example, being that I made more money than he did. He's felt that if I wanted to whoop his ass, then that would be okay. That was natural. That's how it has always been where he grew up. He did not think that was a problem until I said, it's a problem. And he might have only believed it was a problem because I was the breadwinner. So he had to listen to me. So I just wonder if that's the type of situation that Cornelius is in. That he's witnessing his mama be abusive to a man like that. And he thinks that's how it's supposed to be. He's fine with that because that's how he grew up. And one reason it makes me think that is because he already said in his casting special that his mama is the one who wants him to get married. So he's going to get married to make her happy. It seems like he's already doing something that he doesn't want to do. He's already seeking this union because his mama wants him to do it. Maybe he's not particularly ready for it, but because his mama wants him to do it, he's going to do it. Okay, that's what I'm seeing here. Like, is it possible his mama is punking his daddy? Okay, and he thinks that's normal and acceptable. Is that the possibility here? I'm just curious. I'm just throwing out questions. Okay. Now, we didn't get to see any other car rides besides these two sets. In Sabrina and them car again, she drops a bomb onto Walter that she used to be a stripper for 10 years. Bottoms up, okay? Walter, he seemed alarmed, but he didn't want to slut shame her. Because, you know, in this new day and age, you can't say nothing about nobody's sexuality and what they do with their body. In the sex industry, you know, you can't say nothing about them because then you slut shaming them and that stuff too. And she said, you know, she didn't regret nothing she ever did. She did it for 10 years. She's proud of her life and herself back in that time. So he was like, you know what, it's not as taboo as it was back in the day. So for now, I'm gonna just go past and let the past be the past. You know what I'm saying? You know, it was a red flag for him, but it wasn't a fire engine red flag, you know. I'm trying to understand for him what that red flag would be. Did he automatically assume that being a stripper meant that she was a hoe? Because that's usually the connotation that comes along with it, especially in black strip clubs. But she's half Korean and she might not have been in a fully black strip club. I don't know. But yeah, is that what he's saying? Like, so despite the fact that he was a hoe, he went through a whole phase, you know, just knowing that she may have had one too, as she was working as a stripper, is that where his red flag comes in? I'm not sure. But as of right now, like I said he not finna even worry about it. So, back over in the crazy car. Kamil is over there all tense up against the window, making all the faces and everything like that. And Cornelius is like, what's going on? What's wrong with you? Her issue with him is that he did not answer the question, whatever the question may have been at this particular time. And he said, I did. I said, you know, I could see a relationship with us. I could see a serious relationship. But that ain't what Camille heard. She heard him dodging the question. That's what she heard. In the confessionals, he's like, you know what? I'm sensing that this relationship is going to be a lot of work. This is going to be tough. Where did you get that from, Cornelius? Where did you have that notion? I'm saying. So she like, you know what, whatever. I'm not mad. She not mad at all. She just manipulating you. That's all it is. That's all she doing. So everybody arrives at the big manor. I think it's Sherwood Manor. They in the town of Sherwood Manor, which is in Maryland. It looks like Frank and Sydney may have arrived together, or at least at the same time. Naeem is there already. He spins Zadia around, picks her up, gives her a big kiss. And she's like, oh, okay. She wasn't expecting that. It looks like Aisha rolled up with Dante. Phil, he slide in the door. Shiloh already there. Frank gives Aisha the biggest hug. And I'm like, what happened to their connection? That seemed to just fade away. But why? What happened to that connection? Mumin walks in and she sees the piano, right? Now, her and Walter are both musicians. I told y'all that before during the casting special, that not only is Walter a host, even though he has a profession as an engineer, he also sings as well. And Mumin, that's what she does for a living, is sing. So apparently, they wrote a song together, right? Stay right. I don't think there's any other words to the song. I don't think there's no other words than stay right. I don't think there's no other words. Any other words? I mean, so I'm gonna give y'all some new words to put in there and see if I can fill it in. Hold on. Me. Wait, let me wear my whistle. Let me wear my. Stay right. Okay, hello. Stay right. I feel my worst. Now don't you dare look over there. I don't care if they're standing there, cause all you need to do is stay right, stay right, stay right. Stay right, stay right, stay right. Stay right, stay right, stay right. Right here with me. As long as you stay right with me. Stay right, stay right, stay right. I need you to stay right, baby. I need you to stay right, baby. Stay right with me. Then you get the ad lib. Now, don't try to play me to the left. If you won't, okay? All your bad's gonna be to the left. If you don't, stay right with me. Fuck around and find out, y'all. You already know which one is the best. Don't look to the left. Stay right, stay right, stay right. I know that was horrible, but they can use that. Y'all can use that if y'all want to. Stay right, stay right. Oh, God bless America. I don't think that's going to be a banger. I don't think that's going to be a banger. My version or theirs. Anyway, Dante, he going through the house looking for a room to stay in. He run up on Zadia's room. Hey, Zadia, what's up? You know what I'm saying? Now, Zadia say that he... her number one connection, but she didn't greet him. Okay? I don't even think she looked up at him when he spoke. She surely didn't embrace him or give him a kiss like Naeem did. You know what I'm saying? He like, you know what? I'm just trying to find a room. I ain't trying to bother you, sis. She like, well, go look on the other side of the house. Okay? Is that how we playing it? You know what I'm saying? This already let me know. This ain't finna work. And he feeling the same way. He's like, you know what? She number one on my list, but it don't feel like the feelings being reciprocated. So, you know, I like Aisha as well. Let me see what's going on with her. Let me take this time and opportunity to check out what she got going down. Because I'm trying to give Zadia my all, and she playing me to the left. You know what I'm saying? She should have stayed right, stay right, stay right. You know what I'm saying? Look her. Zadia don't want you, Dante. If Zadia pretends that she wants you, it's that's because you want somebody else. That child don't want you. Zadia has to be number one in whoever's life she gets involved in. Naeem seems to be putting her number one. You have three kids and three baby mamas. She will never be number one in your life. Never be number one. Those kids will always come first. And she knows that. She knows if you, any of the man that you claim to be for your children, Zadia is not going to be number one. She is not going to rock with you. Okay? Telling you that right now. Right? So, Tommy, he comes in and he tells them that in the morning, one of y'all men got to go. Okay? So, I'm thinking, let's see. Walter ain't going nowhere because he brought Sabrina. I don't think Cornelius is going anywhere either because he gave the ride to Kamil and Zadia. Phil, he ain't going nowhere. He got too many options. Dante, I don't think he leaving either because he feeling Aisha now. We gotta see where this goes. We have to see where it goes. And because of that, now I understand more clearly the beef with Zadia and Aisha. This just wasn't about Cornelius because like Zadia was felt like she was taking up for Kamil in regards to Cornelius because of Aisha voted Cornelius every week as being her bottom. And that's why she claims that she's a hater, right? So now on top of this, now the other man that you claim you wanted is feeling Aisha too? Yeah, Zadia got a problem with that. Okay, Zadia got a real problem with that. Let's see. Frank, he ain't going nowhere either. So that leaves Naeem. That leaves Naeem. I think he's going home. So let's see if I'm right. Well, Walter, he's saying he feel like his connections are solid. Right? He's been very truthful, very upfront, but on this journey, you just don't know. And I already let me know you finna have some problems this episode. You're about to have some problems. I honestly do not think that Walter is here looking for a long-term commitment with either of these two women. He wants kids. Sabrina doesn't. She's very adamant about that. He desires sex. He's a sexual being in his relationship. Mumin wants to wait until marriage before having sex. She has a maturity about herself, but she's not mature enough for Walter. He wants kids. He does not want to date one. I think he's just enjoying both of their companies at this point. Okay. Prime example, Walter. He had the keys, the piano, if you didn't know where the keys are. This time he's up with Sabrina. They not writing no song, but he playing, I think, Mumin's song to her. And Mumin sees them, and at first she does an about face, right? A 180. And she tells Kamil, oh, he's in there at the piano. He got another duet going on, right? And Kamil had to say, let's go back. Let's go in there. I'll go with you. Because they both come in and stand at the piano. They first look at each other. Kamil had this look on her face that said to me, so what you gonna do, girl? What you gonna do, right? Get your man. So Mumin walks around Kamil. She goes over to Walter's side. First, she's leaning in on the piano. He's still playing. Sabrina's sipping her wine. So she decides to cozy up a little bit more with Walter. He's like, oh, okay, that's good, right? Then Mumin decides to start caressing the back of his neck. And I'm like, really, girl, how immature is this? She playing games now. And if you are aware that he has a connection already to Sabrina, you see him sitting in here with Sabrina, and you claim you are respecting the process, how about show some respect right now to what he got going on? Or better yet, just show some couth. At least in this moment, okay? You can have a conversation with him about it later. But right now, all this touchy-touchy feeling on his neck while he's sitting next to Sabrina, his other connection, that's some childish stuff right there. That was real childish. And Walter wasn't buying into that. He wasn't buying into it at all. He's like, didn't you see Kamil post up in front of Cornelius to see like what's really about to go down? Like, okay, let's see what he about to do. I think she wanted fireworks. She wanted Mumin to pop off. If not Mumin, she wanted to get under Sabrina's skin enough to make her pop off. Remember, she wants the drama. She wants the beef, okay? But I think Mumin is, even though she's feeling some kind of way, she ain't want no beef like that. She really was trying to get away from all that mess at this particular point, which is why she walked off, right? Kamil, like I say, I think she wanted to see something pop. What Walter say, y'all funny. And when he said y'all, he was talking about Mumin and Kamil. Now Sabrina kept her cool. Cornelius is right there trying to referee the craziness after Mumin walk out the room. And Mumin's like, I just can't. Got your feelings hurt, didn't you? Got your feelings hurt listening to your crazy ass cousin. That's what you got, your feelings hurt. Okay, so poolside, Frank and Sydney, they out there chatting. You know, she said that even though she's vibing with Phil, she really feels Frank. It's, they just had an instant connection. For Sydney and Phil, I think it's all physical. She said last week that the only reason why she wanted to check for him was because he wasn't checking for her. Something about that don't sit right with me, right? He was ignoring her, so she's like, okay, I'm gonna go after him then, right? But once she got in, that's all I see is sexual energy between the two of them. I would say Phil stick with Shiloh, but we really ain't seen him interact with Shiloh but one time for real. You seem to have sexual energy with her, and you said she makes you feel vulnerable, okay? You had this great vibe with Aisha. But I think with Aisha, for lack of a better term, Phil will be her Captain Saberho. You know what I'm saying? And he would have to do too much emotional care with Aisha. So he likes the place that he's in with Shiloh. Stick with Shiloh. And like I said, Sydney is body to him. You know what I'm saying? She paid good money for it. Shit. You know, it's eye catch. I understand. So Naeem, Claude, have mercy. I love his damn body. He got that I used to run track body in his skin. Shea butter, baby, fucking up my pillows. I instantly thought of that when I saw Naeem sitting by that poolside, all up. I'm rooting for him. I'm really rooting for him. But Zadia ain't it, bro. Zadia ain't in. I think you're on a maturity level that she ain't there. And she ain't on that yet. Zadia says she stirred up drama between Kamil and Cornelius, but she didn't mean to. She started asking them what was Cornelius' intentions with Kamil. And he like, what? Are you her mama? Well, I said, are you her mama? He like, what are you, the friends gate right now? You know what I'm saying? Well, why are you asking him questions about his intentions? He like, are you like trying to up their journey or something? You trying to skip and get to the final part or something like that? And she's like, yeah, you know, just a little bit, but it was worth it. It was all worth it. How was any of that worth it for you? How is that add value to what you're doing here in this process? I don't understand that shit. Pay attention to your own shit, okay? For him, he said he likes where they are. He can see the possibility of them. But she basically wants him to say where he stands. Like, he chooses her. That's what she wants to hear at this particular point. She says she don't want to put all her eggs in his basket and he ain't like checking for her like that. She wants confirmation from both men. She wants both men to say, I want you. But you're not making that choice either, sis. You know what I'm saying? So, Shiloh, she's trying to find out for sure where Phil stands too, because she knows he had a lot of connections. If it wasn't for him, she would not be there, because who else is checking for Shiloh? Okay? He basically said, you already know how I feel about you, but does she? Does she? Because Phil, you are good at talking around conversation. You're really good at not like saying who is your number one at this time. So how do you feel about her? That's what she's trying to find out. But speaking of feelings, Mumin is in hers right now, okay? Walter by her side, they at the poolside, and she got much attitude for him. Very much attitude for him. He looked like, look her, let's stop playing these games, okay? I'm not trying to intercede on you when you with your other connections. Don't do that to me. Stop being petty. You know, be classy. Why he say that to her? Why he say that to her? Her crazy was about to come out, right? She was about to show us why her and Camille are really cousins. That's what she was about to do. But she told him she feel like Sabrina, she didn't say her name, but who else was she talking about, is manipulating him into not trusting her. Where are you getting this from? What trust issues have been displayed that I'm missing? What they haven't shown us in the editing room? He just said, don't trip off of me when I'm with my other connections. Like, I don't trip off of you. I'm going to afford you that same thing. Okay? How did that translate into I don't trust you? Goodbye. Goodbye. So, like I said, she was going to show us her crazy right there. But then she decided, you know what? I'm going to get up and I'm going to walk away. Because I'm a child of God. I'm going to walk away. But the problem is they were still in mid-conversation. They hadn't finished talking. They hadn't resolved anything. She gets up and walk away as if she's having a damn temper tantrum. Well, inside the house, Aisha in there cooking. She about to burn, baby. Why the cameraman focus on her ass? Y'all so wrong for that. They shady. Anywho, she knew that Dante was a vegan, so she got him some vegan food options, some vegan sausage or what have you. And she let him know, the kitchen ain't the only place that I burn, baby. It ain't the only place that I burn. I throw down other places, too. And in case you fall in love with me, I wear a size 7. I'm just letting you know. I'm not understanding why they only had phone conversations, though. Like, what was the reason why these two couldn't hook up outside of the show? It seems like the show has a contingency plan on some people on whether or not they could see each other outside of these gates. Okay. Yeah, I realize we've never seen Shiloh on a date. We saw her go out with Phil, with Carrie. Remember when Carrie was around? It was Phil, Carrie, and Dante. That's the only date we've seen her on other than the friends and family's dates. Oh, she had the one date with, what's the dude? Crazy ass. She had a date with him. But other than that, we haven't seen her have any real dates. No, she didn't have a date with him. That was elimination. Right? What's that elimination? I don't remember. No, I don't remember. But we ain't really seen much of Shiloh either. We ain't really seen much of Shiloh. Actually, we haven't seen a lot of dates at all. Now I'm thinking about it. Camille and Cornelius? Other than the group dates that they had with Corey, when did they go on the other dates? All this drama and confliction that they had, when was that? The last date we saw them was when they was at the skating ring, right? It's a group thing. Yeah, we haven't seen many dates at all since Corey left the show, other than Sean, I think. Well, Camille says that Cornelius was stressed out before they headed up there, so she wanted to plan a solo date for them. Their date was he brought her some water. That was it. It wasn't a food. They wouldn't consume no food. Nothing like that. She gave him a necklace to express her love and admiration for him. She knows how to use God. Throw in the Lord when she need to bend Cornelius to her will. And you might as well call his ass origami. I swear for goodness. She says that in a very short time, they have been through a lot. Enough to make them both want to walk away from one another. I was like, tell me more. Tell me more, right? Because the cameras ain't showing all that. Cornelius is like, you wasn't going to walk away. She's like, yes, we both were going to walk away. I think the only time I remember where she felt like she could walk away from him is when Sydney came in the picture and he was talking to her. And she's like, oh, no, he's talking to my man. She's talking, and remember she flipped out and Mami had to calm my ass down. That's the only time I think she ever said that she didn't want to be with Cornelius. It was over. It was over. Whatever. Anyway, that damn necklace should feel like a noose around his doggone neck. It really should. She got her wolf clamps in him deep. Now he's telling us that she could be a little messy. I'm like, a little, bro, for real, okay? But and now he's questioning whether or not that they are moving too fast. She tells him that he better not take the damn necklace off, ever. Boy, she sounds like so many abusive ass niggas that I know. Not that I've dated, I just know. She sounds just like these motherfuckers. Don't take that necklace off. You better wear it every doggone day. She gets under my skin, y'all. Under my skin. And she be watching all these logo reviews from all these shows. You get under my skin, girl. Let him take it off for one doggone second. She gonna have his head. She gonna be on his head. The producers asked him, don't you think Camille is a bit controlling? He was like, y'all trying to get me in trouble. Is that your answer for everything? You can't speak on anything without worrying about being in trouble with Camille. Somebody you just met 9 weeks ago. Let you tell it. Well, they at the dinner table again, right? He sits next to her. She say, I need you to sit across from me so I can look into your face. Aisha is like, Cornelius, you good? You good? Blink twice, you know what I'm saying? Set up a smoke signal, you know, shoot a flare. Hoo-hoo, do something, dog. Let us know that you all right. And I don't know if this is editing, but everybody outside of that Brown Girl crew looked concerned for him. Everybody starts to state their opinion about the elimination, you know. And Cornelius is like, you know, I hate to see anybody go at this point. And Dante says, you know, there seems to be some type of possessiveness from Camille. It couldn't be me. Because she says to Cornelius, you good, boo. You ain't got to worry about nothing. You already made your connection. Too bad, so sad that I sprinted and everybody else had a marathon, right? So she told everybody, see y'all at the reunion. Well, Aisha's like, well, everybody got their own way to go through this process. And just because y'all sprinted, don't mean the dog got processed out, you know what I'm saying? He may still very well end up at the bottom because he hasn't made any connections with anybody else. This half a hoe said, if y'all put him in the bottom, I will fuck y'all up. I wish a bitch would. In other words, if Dante couldn't be me, it couldn't be me. My thing is, if y'all connection that damn strong, him getting off the voted off the show shouldn't change anything. Matter of fact, you could leave out the fucking door with him for all I care, right? Do you need the cameras on in order for your relationship to be real? Is that what the problem is, girl? Bye. See you later. Bye. Go, right? Anywho, Camille slipped into her theatrics, like I said, if that you already made your connection. I was like, girl. Even Mumin was looking at her like, cuz, calm down. You crazy for real. You're doing a little bit too much. Everybody is kind of over them. Sabrina's like, I'm not going to say nothing. Sydney over there taking deep sighs, like, you know. Aisha's like, oh, sometimes I wish I drank. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling you, that Gemini is about to come out of her. When she started clapping, I said, there it comes. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. Basically, she was saying everybody needs connections. Everybody deserves to have real connections with everyone in some kind of way. And he may have missed his opportunity because shit, you won't let him do anything. You won't let him breathe. You got a chokehold on him. Right? My words, not hers. Somehow, Zadia jumped into the conversation and was telling Aisha that she hating because they already got a connection. Ain't nobody hating. Has nothing to do with hate. And what she say? I ain't got a hater bone in my doggone body. Not a hater bone. It's amazing how Zadia keep inserting herself in conversations. But then when everybody else say something, they need to shut up and just deal with the hell what she's saying, right? She always the one that's right. Aisha like, hold up. Like I said, ain't no hater bone in my body. So, you know, stay over there with that. Naeem was already trying to interject and calm them down. That fell on deaf ears. Bill got up, came around to the table to talk to Aisha and try to calm her down and pull out the room. Mumin came over to Aisha's side. Shocking. Dante came over to Aisha's side. One moment, Shiloh was over there on Aisha's side. And Zadia said, this ain't the first time that Aisha got diarrhea of the mouth. I was like, you know, you don't think you got diarrhea of the mouth? I was so wrong about Zadia. Oh, I hate to say that I was so wrong about her. But when her true color started to show, I clocked her ass. I clocked her ass quick. She is a full-on gutter snipe. If you don't know what a gutter snipe is, look it up. And you can come back here and tell me whether or not she is a gutter snipe with her actions. I hate Aisha let them get under her skin to the point that she got loud. But I understood. Like, you say this ain't her first time. I'm quite sure this ain't your first time either. You know what I'm saying? I think at this point, Aisha is tired of them. Period. Phil and Dante, they was able to escort her out, but she was still hot, you know. And trust me, the reason why she stayed loud, because she wanted them motherfuckers to hear every word she had to say. She don't want it to be like, the Aisha said this. No, you're going to hear what Aisha had to say. Which is, of course, Zadia saying, you know, she's still talking out the side of her neck, right? Naeem is like, Zadia is a bit extra, but, you know, he wanted her to do a better job and walk away from the situation. Walk away from the pettiness. She can't do that because she is petty. Petty is her name. And at the table, Zadia is saying, you know, she needed to know that she wasn't making any damn sense. Mumin say, but did that help? I don't care if he helped or not. She just needed to know. Basically, Zadia just needed to get her point across. Cornelius claimed it was childish, too. He thought, you know, they should even went there. And he was the first one to say, fuck them up. Like, what? No, that's not what we finna do. But, yeah. Now it's so in doubt. No, it ain't. You stop lying, boy. Stop lying. Well, Dante hollers at Zadia, right? Like, why are you provoking a situation? She's like, it wasn't a situation. It wasn't no heated debate. He's like, yes, it was. And you were there being petty, poke, provoking things. You know what I'm saying? And she's like, no, I didn't. He's like, yes, you did. And she's like, well, did I? Yes, you did. And I'm so glad that he said something. But again, he is the one who actually said something to Kamil before, too. He was the one that told Kamil about how she acted and everything. Remember that? Yeah, he told that girl she was nutted in some nuts in a jock sack. She's nutted in a jock strap. But Zadia does not feel like she did anything out of pocket or anything out of place. She actually found it funny. What concerned her most is the fact that Dante was siding with Aisha. When he got up and stood by her side, baby, he was siding with her. Okay. Hey. Hell, Mumin, Sydney, Phil, Sabrina, Shiloh, they was all siding with her at this point, to be honest. Anywho, she tried to turn it on him and make it seem like he was at fault for wanting an understanding, for wanting a peaceful environment and he was like, see, you doing it again right now. I guess that's just a part of her personality. And that's what he was saying too. And she like, what's the point of my personality? You playing like you don't have no accountability. Like, you know, that's what it is. I'll tell you, you act like you don't have any accountability for your actions. He said, like, what the fuck is your agenda here? I don't understand it. Just like what Mumin said at the table, did all that shit help? And you was like, I don't care if it helped or not. Then what is your agenda? What is your agenda? To negate everyone else's opinion just to be doing it? Dante's like, you know what? I think it's time for me to exit the Zadia boat. You know what I'm saying? Time for me to disengage. What I was trying to tell her to do. Disengage. But she was like, disengage. Wow. Okay, coach. Whatever you say. That's how she was feeling. So Phil chatted up with Aisha about the whole little situation, and she's like, you know what, I feel like this was the time and the moment. I needed to say what I had to say, had to put it on the table. I'm so sick and tired of them and they BS. I need to take a stance, and I'm not apologizing for it either. I meant what I said, okay? Then all of a sudden, in glass Dante, and I mean glide in. He came in silk robe, smooth, chest all out, smooth voice, body all glistening. Phil was like, what the hell is going on? This dude come here looking like Prince and shit. I can't compete with that. He said it's got to be the smoothest way he ever lost a woman before in his life, you know. Well, Dante feel like Aisha had a hard day. He needed to help her relieve her stress, so he set up a massage for her, baby. He was massaging her back. She done got comfortable enough to take off her dog on top. He got her assets, you know, all in his hands, and he gonna make love to them cheeks, baby. They put the camera crew out, okay? Aisha is not shy on making a physical connection with these people. She's not shy at all. Okay, next morning at breakfast, Frank is like, you know, take note at the calm energy at the table. Who not there? The brown girl crew, their honorary member Cornelius, and Naeem. Okay, so Tommy showed up for the ladies' choice, but first let's touch on what's been going down. Kamil tried to pussyfoot around the situation. Aisha like, no, these hoes be tripping, you know, my words, not hers. Then Zadia say, some people just have a hater in them, okay? Your words don't match what you actually say, or the meaning don't match what you actually say, whatever. So Aisha say, you know what, you've always got something smart to say. You aggressive as fuck. Everybody like, whoa, 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 not aggressive. Sitting over there like, yeah, aggressive, you know. And she like, what we not gonna do is call me aggressive. Look, Zadia, you provoke situations, okay? You are being aggressive. Call a spade a spade. I know we as black people don't like to use the word aggressive because white people have used it to like belittle us and make us feel like we can't speak our minds, or when we speak our minds that we being like at them, or we attacking them, whatever. But bitch, is being aggressive. You are being aggressive. The fuck? What are you talking about? Don't call me aggressive. I'm calling a spade a fucking spade. That's what you're doing right now. I don't like that term. I don't like that term. Well, I don't like when your ass try to tag team in every fucking conversation as if your opinion the only one that matter. Like, the fuck, okay? You fucking aggressive, motherfucker. Shit. Well, Tommy's only way to handle this situation is to move on, okay? Sabrina feeling Walter, who means connection with Walter has been broken. Aisha feeling Dante. Zadia says that Dante has replaced her with Aisha. And he wrong for not sharing that with her. Okay. Sydney is Frank. Team Frank. Sabrina says Cornelius ain't ready to love. If he keep ignoring a real flash from Kamil. Kamil is child as a fuck. Need to grow up. I mean, get mad if you want to, Kamil. You called yourself immature in the beginning. And you ain't lied about that. So, bottom of the list. Zadia said Walter is here to play and not love. I agree, but I think she only did that because of Mumin. Sabrina said Cornelius. Then Mumin said she don't think that he ready for this. Who are you talking about? They edited that in, it looked like to me. And then because they came in with Aisha just talking about Cornelius afterward in the confessional. But it wouldn't make sense for Mumin to go against the brown girl crew, now would it? Unless Mumin still has some bit of integrity about herself and she's going to be true to the fucking process. I don't have a connection with Cornelius. That's the only person I really don't have a connection with the most. I'm going to say his fucking name. Okay? She's like, you ain't finna whoop my ass, cuz. Okay? I know you said, claim you're going to fuck everybody up, but that ain't what you finna do to me. Anywho. Shiloh said, no, he being punked. You know, into not opening up to anybody else. And the only one he opened up to is the person that's punking him. My words, not hers. Naeem, that's the next person. Sydney said it. He not putting in any effort. Mumin says he seems a bit distracted. But Mumin's conversation seemed like it was the same one when they was talking about Cornelius. That's why I said that part was edited. But again, it seems like Mumin is going against the brown girl crew. And they looking at her funny. They threw her some looks. You know what I'm saying? Shiloh, she said it. It seemed like she was finishing her editing statement too about Cornelius, whatever. Aisha said Naeem is just a bit up and down. Now, after all these people said these things about Naeem, the only one that, what's that girl name? Zadia take issue with is Aisha. You're not going to be insulting his character. He has been a very genuine person. I didn't hear anybody say he wasn't genuine. Her statement was about him. Then she made a statement saying that I told him that he could have friends. You telling this grown man he can have friends? Like, that sounds a bit controlling to me, Zadia. That sounds a bit controlling to me. So, Zadia is over there about to cry, bucket full of tears. Her and Kamil holding each other's hands, trying to support each other. If Diane go, then she basically out the game because she's already lost Dante. Her and Kamil, like I said, they holding hands and everything. If Cornelius go, I want Kamil to walk out the door after him. But if not, she gone anyway. Ain't nobody else feeling her too. And I'm like, who you gonna fuck up, sis? Your man in the bottom. Your man in the bottom. Okay. Cornelius and Naeem, both of y'all men in the bottom. But like I said, I don't think Cornelius going anywhere because he two people's right. And Naeem, I had hopes for you, bro. Just Zadia just wasn't it. If you go, Zadia going next week. Okay. So Zadia meets up with Naeem, but he got a feeling this is an elimination. Kamil has to meet it with Cornelius. Y'all noticed that every time he walks into the room in this particular episode, he got flowers for her. And both of them, look, Kamil is crying and Cornelius is trying to calm her down. And we don't get the answer this week. So we got to wait till next week to find out who actually get eliminated. And again, I still think it's going to be Naeem. Y'all let me know what y'all thought. I didn't realize this review was going to be this long. I'm glad the video didn't cut off. Thank y'all for being here. Thank y'all for being patient. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Peace.